they are now all over Africa, you know, buying things and investing over there and getting those countries dependent on them and supporting, you know, non-democratic people. And I'm just
like whom?
Well,
we are in a country that supports Saudi Arabia.
Yes, that's true. Right. So
suddenly we have a problem with, you know, superpowers supporting non-democratic people.
Yes. I mean, yes, I do. But I also am just concerned that we've sort of created the economic power that China sort of has now, and they're using it, I fear, going to be using it against us eventually and against the better interests of a lot of people.
Allow me to put your mind to rest.
Okay. Great.
You shouldn't worry about that.
Okay.
It's very simple. And let me explain why you shouldn't worry about that. But please continue.
Well, I mean, they're in Africa. They're lending money to countries to build ports and different infrastructure.
To build what?
Port harbors.
And what's wrong with that?
And, well, because
countries that need ports get ports.
But they're making people dependent on, I mean, I know, it's the same thing that we've done, which is
no, it's
horrible
not.
Around the world.
They are far more humanistic than the United States ever was.
Really? Okay.
Absolutely.
Great. So
let me give you an example. Of course they are peddling for influence.
Yeah.
Yeah? But they are non-interventionist. Absolutely non-interventionist in a way that Europeans, the West, has never managed to fathom.
But I have a feeling they have a longer-term thought process that is more interventionist.
But let's
anyway,
judge what so, we no. see. Let's
okay.
judge what.
Okay.
Well, let's start at the beginning. The Chinese never asked Apple to go to Shenzhen and produce all the iPhones. It was Steve Jobs that decided that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was not China that went to Washington, D.C. and demanded that they buy a third of your national debt. If they hadn't bought it, you would be in serious trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Number three. I did allude to this in my talk. If in 2008 China had not cranked up their credit bubble, you would be in a new Great Depression now.
Mm-hmm.
So, China, the United States, and the European Union are absolutely synergistic, and they need one another in a way that if we fail to acknowledge and to nurture billions of people, including the majority of the people in this country, are going to suffer. When it comes to the influence of China outside its borders, I have to say, firstly, it's quite remarkable that they don't seem to have any military ambitions. Secondly, Africa. I'll give you an example, a specific example. Ethiopia. 2004, because it happened to be there, and I have some first-hand experience of it. They went into Ethiopia. I'll tell you why they went into Ethiopia, because they suspected there was oil. Because China is a major industrial power, but it lacks primary resources. Now, instead of going into Africa with troops, colonially, destroying the country, killing people like the West has done for the last 100 years, what they did was they went to Addis Ababa and they said to the government, we would like, we can see you have problems with your infrastructure, we would like to build some new airports, upgrade your railway system, create a telephone system, and rebuild your roads. And we'll do this all for free. No strings attached. We don't want anything from you. And they did. Why did they do it? Because it's soft power. Because because they knew that if oil is discovered, and it was discovered later, then, of course, the Ethiopian government will be much more open to Chinese oil companies coming there. They have never combined their investment with imperialistic